India's benchmark BSE Sensex scaled a new peak on Friday when it touched the 60,000 mark, closing the day at 60,048.47 after crossing 60,300 intraday. The rally from 50,000 to the present milestone has been quick, especially given the devastating second wave of COVID-19 that ravaged the country in April and May. The Sensex first crossed the 50,000 mark in January and ended above that level for the first time the following month. There has been a sustained rally since then, with the occasional dip. Several market players are predicting the Sensex will touch the 100,000 mark within the next couple of years. The index has jumped about 25% since January 1, when it was closed at 47,868.99. Twitter lit up with enthusiastic responses to the Sensex landmark on Friday, with jubilant comments such as India had become the world's sixth biggest stock market, having overtaken France in market capitalization, which was estimated at $3.41 trillion that day. The Sensex closed at 60,077.88 on Monday. Milesh Shah, managing director at Kotak Mahindra Asset Management, says the Indian equity markets are running up on sentiments, flows and fundamentals. Opening up of the economy, increasing pace of vaccinations and falling active cases are turning sentiments positive, Shah said. In addition, the debt crisis at China's second largest real estate developer, Evergrande, seemed to have eased. On the domestic front, industry experts say the Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government has made some right moves by taking a series of reform measures, principal among them being the outlining of a national monetization pipeline, assets that are to be leased to the private sector to generate money. The government recently announced procedural and structural changes to help the ailing sector and address the liquidity concerns of telecom industry participants. The measures include rationalization of adjusted gross revenue, what constitutes telecom revenues, fixed spectrum tenure and a timetable for spectrum auction. Industry captains say that the economy has bottomed out and will be on an upswing hereafter, reaching pre-COVID levels in another 6 months.